half a dozen lousy aspirin. That's all I'm asking for.
Come back in 4 hours if it's still bothering you. And if it is, I'll arrange for you to see the doctor.
Thanks a million.
I mean, I've always been against fighting. It seems so unnecessary to hurt each other.
Really? I thought you were in for murder.
Well, I can explain about that.
Who the hell do you reckon you're pushing around?
Oh, oh, oh,
get up against the wall.
Stand up.
Oh, yeah. Ah, you don't look too good, Kate. Maybe you should see a doctor or something.
Let's eat.
Yeah.
Kate!
Who got you, Bryant?
Anyone with her?
Yes.
That duck's Doreen.
I think the other one was called Hazel.
Do you believe me now? Do you understand about those slobs? Don't worry. We'll pay them back. But no more talking, okay? I told you before, they only understand one thing.
So,
are you with me or not?
Yes. You can count me in.
Kate Peterson, she's a stuck-up bitch, all right. Reckon she knows every bloody thing just because she's been to uni. Well, I reckon she'll get a real education in here. Don't you think so, Jude?
What?
I said she's going to get a real education in here. I mean, with 15 years to serve, it only stands to reason she's got to learn something.
Yeah.
Well, do you agree or don't you?
I said yes, didn't I?
Well, I thought you'd be on top of the world after what we've just done.
Well, I'm not so sure.
Well, how's that?
Well, I'm a bit worried about her, you know. She wasn't even at lunch.
She's probably got a big gut ache.
I'm not so sure about that, love. My God, you know, she may really come in here to talk to us.
Talk? She was snooping. Look at this. I mean, this was in the drawer before that Peterson bitch came in here.
Are you sure?
No, not exactly. But who cares?
Well, I do.
Well, she's got what coming to her anyway.
Look, I'm worried about her.
Well, I'm not.
Do me a favor, will you?
What?
Just go and find out.
Find out what?
Find out how she is. That Hazel packs a pretty mean punch, you know.
I couldn't care less. If she was at death's door, I wouldn't be lifting a finger to help her.
Now, that's not true, Doreen. If she really is hurt, you're going to be in the hot seat the same as anyone else.
Why don't you go and check on her, seeing you're so worried?
I can't. I don't have time. I'm due back in reception. You know, Doreen, you're really amazing. 5 minutes ago, you're all over me to be top dog.
Of course, I'm with you all the way.
Well, then why don't you do as I ask? Honey, come on. Just go and poke your little nose around the door and see if she's okay. Is that so difficult?
All right, I'll do it. But I'm only doing it for you. If I had me way, I'd let her rot.
Good on you, kid.
Oh, hello, Janet.
Hi.
Are there any biscuits?
I think there's some over there.
Oh. Do you want one?
No, thanks. I've
gotta watch my weight.
Come on.
Well, you know what they say? You can't be either too rich or too thin.
Who's they?
I think it was Jackie Onassis.
Oh, she'd know. Talking of undeserved riches, have you seen the new TV?
What TV?
A brand new colour television has just been delivered to the rec room.
Oh, I thought the rec fund was broke.
Apparently it was donated by Mr. Conway. You know, from Conway Discounts.
Very generous of him.
Oh, say. Hey, no relation of yours, is he?
Or would I be working here if I had relations like that? I
suppose not. I wonder why he did it.
Well, you know what people are like. They feel guilty and then they donate things so that they feel better. And it's also a tax dodge.
I'm sure it's not as straightforward as that. I mean, if rumours are to be believed, B. Smith was behind it.
Huh?
God alone knows how she arranged it.
Well, I imagine with Bee's contacts, she'd find it very easy.
But Bee's been inside for years. It's not as though she'd have known contacts that she could put pressure on, you know, before she came in here.
She's still a very powerful woman.
What makes you say that?
Well, look at the way she runs things around here.
The officers ran Wentworth when I was here.
You know what I mean, the way that she controls the other women. Now, it stands to reason that she could set up a deal like that.
Sorry.
I was just...
What were you just?
Bea sent me. She was looking for this book.
Did she know?
Yeah. So I suppose I'd better be getting back to the laundry.
Oh, don't rush off on my account.
Oh, I wouldn't bother.
Just as long as you know who gives the orders around here.
Yeah, Bea does.
That's a giggle.
Well, Jude does now. So you needn't think that you're going to be...
Oh! I needn't think what?
Oh!
I needn't think what? I needn't think that I'm top dog, is that it?
I never said nothing.
But you were going to, weren't you?
No, I never said it.
I'm running this joint now, understand?
Understand?
No.
Good. And Kate's a very good friend of mine. Remember that.
And if you forget, I'll be quite happy to give you another little reminder.
What's going on here?
How do you mean?
Heard you threatening Doreen.
Who, me?
What happened, Doreen?
Nothing, Mrs. Morris.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Doreen, you can trust me. I heard you've been threatened, and I want to know why.
Sandy never threatened me.
So be a good girl and butt out.
Don't you speak to me like that.
You're forgetting yourself, Meg. You've got no authority here now. You're a counsellor, not a screw.
Thank you for the reminder.
So why don't you just go away and mind your own business?
Well, perhaps Doreen would like to come with me.
Doreen's paying a social call. Aren't you, Dor?
Yeah. Well, I reckon I'd better get back to the laundry.
Not till I tell you.
Well, they're going to send a screw after me if
when
I don't get back.
When I say so. You learned your lesson?
Yeah.
Good girl. Now get the hell out of here. And don't come back.
Come in.
Sorry, more paperwork.
Ah, no rest for the wicked, eh? By the way, I haven't had your report on the rec room fight. Have you written it up yet?
No, I've decided to let it go.
Why? You're perfectly within your rights, you know.
Perhaps, but, well, I think I overreacted. I mean, what happened with the television was an accident, and what followed was more of a scuffle than a fight. And you're right, I just need more experience.
Right.
Well, I hope I'm not making more paperwork, saying one thing and then changing my mind.
Oh, don't worry about that. We all do that at one time or another. You are right, though. With Vera gone and Meg determined not to come back again, things are getting a bit critical. We're very short on experienced officers.
Maybe Meg will reconsider.
Well, I've tried to talk her around, but I can't seem to get through to her. Maybe I'll have better luck next time.
Yes. Well, I better get back to the salt mines.
Yeah. Oh, Janet. Thanks very much for last night. I really did enjoy it.
Well, I should thank you. It's been a long time since I've had the opportunity to bore anyone with my life story.
Oh, no, not at all. I was just sorry that you had to leave so early.
Well, it was you who put me on the early shift.
Yeah, right. Well, that won't happen again.
Then she reckoned I could go.
Well, what did you do?
What do you reckon, Dumbo?
Gee, lucky to get out of there with your head still on your shoulders.
Yeah, well, she shouldn't be allowed to get away with it.
I know, but what can we do?
Well, if we all stuck together, she wouldn't have such an easy time of it, would she?
Well, I'm with you all the way.
All the way to where, Hazel? Oh. I hate to interrupt the mothers' meeting, but I had a funny feeling I was being talked about.
We was just saying.
Would you like me to go away and give you half an hour to make up a nice little story? Didn't Doreen tell you about our little chat this afternoon?
Yeah.
You wouldn't like me to talk to you like that, would you, Hazel?
No, of course not, Sandy.
Get me a book, will you, love?
What book?
On second thoughts, the newspaper.
You a cripple or something?
You've got a short memory. Thanks, Hayes.
Don't mention it. My pleasure, Sandy.
Oh, you scab!
Hold your horses.
Oh, sorry, Miss Conway.
Well, what's the problem?
No problem.
Oh, come on, Doreen. Something's up, I can tell.
Honest, there's no problem. It's just that the air gets a bit stuffy in there, you know?
Everything all right in here?
Yeah, right as rain. Why shouldn't it be?
Hazel?
Yeah, sure, Miss Conway. Everything's real good.
Well, Doreen seemed a little upset.
I wouldn't take much notice. After you've been here a while, you get used to Doreen's little moods.
Do you? Well, I happen to have been here longer than you have, Edwards.
What do you reckon, Hazel? Am I right or wrong?
Yeah. Dor goes troppo all the time. We don't take no notice no more.
There you go. All quiet on the Western Front, as they say.
Good. Well, let's get a move on. It's time for lock-up.
All right, girls. Come on.
Thank you, Edwards.
I should be thanking you, Miss Colway.
Why is that?
For dropping the charges against me and Judy.
There were no charges. Now get a move on.
For a beginner, you've got real nous.
Don't push your luck, Edwards.
No, Richie Didge, I mean it. Even a real experienced screw could have been silly enough to try and press charges. But not you. I like that. Keep up the good work. Come on, kiddies, bedtime.
How is Kate?
I don't know.
Well, I suppose if she was seriously hurt, we would have heard by now.
That's all you can think about, isn't it?
Doreen, I know you copped it. I'm sorry.
Sorry, are you? Well, you're safe and sound in reception. I'm getting bashed.
I'm sorry, honey. If I'd known there was going to be any danger, I would have gone myself. But I thought since Kate was interested in talking about it...
Oh, talk. That's all you do, and I get thumped. Hazel's chickened out on us. And the next thing you know, I reckon you'll be down on your hands and knees licking Sandy's boots.
That's not true, and you know it.
Well, I think it is, after all the pussyfooting around you've done.
Do you want to know why I did it? Because I thought B was going to come good and see what was happening.
Look, B's so wrapped in that stupid machine of hers, she couldn't care less what happened to us.
That's not true, Doreen. Still... You are right about one thing. B's not going to get any better.
So what are you going to do?
Got no choice, have I?
You mean you'll take over?
Like I said, I got no choice.
Oh, good on you, Jude. Knew you wouldn't let us down.
Morning, Judy.
Morning.
Judy?
Morning.
What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. Excuse me.
I've been meaning to talk to you. Something's going on. I want to know what it is.
It's sort of something.
Oh, Doreen's in a state.
Doreen's always in a state about one thing or
another. Look, you know what I'm talking about. And it's something to do with Sandy Edwards. I'm sure of it.
Well, if you're sure of it, why ask me?
It's got into you, Judy. Always so cooperative in the past. I am not asking you to lag on anyone. But you could help me to help the women.
That sounds like fence-sitting to me.
Look, why don't we go to the interview room and talk about it? I can see something's bothering you.
Well, that's very perceptive of you, Mrs. Morris.
Look, you won't get anywhere by burying your head in the sand. I just don't understand it. Of all the women, you used to be one of the most sensible.
Maybe it's time for a change, huh?
I hope not.
Look, Mrs. Morris, I'm very busy. Do you mind?
Look, we've got to talk this thing through. If Mr. Fletcher, for example, asked you what was going on, you'd feel obliged to give him a fair hearing, wouldn't you?
Well, you're not Mr. Fletcher, are you? You're not even a screw. And I don't have to say anything to you.
I'm sorry for dragging you away from your duties, Janet, but, here it is. I was wondering if you'd mind doing a double shift for me next weekend. Here.
No, it's fine.
Well, I hate to do this to you, but I'm finding it a bit difficult doing the rosters as well as trying to keep my head above water in here.
Well, is there anything I can do? I mean, I mightn't be much help, but...
No, believe me. Just seeing a pretty face first thing in the morning is enough for me.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's all right, Meg.
I was, just leaving.
Can't get over changing Janet. I mean, she was so worried when she first started.
Yes, she does seem to be finding her feet okay. What about you?
Ah, not too good. I just can't seem to get through to the women these days.
Well, have a seat. Tell me all about it. Which women?
Well, I know it's not my official business, but I overheard Doreen talking to Sandy Edwards and they were having this argument, and when I confronted them, they told me in no uncertain terms where to get off.
Well, you're right. It's not your business, officially.
You think I don't know that? But that doesn't mean to say I don't care about what happens in here.
Well, perhaps if you cared a little bit more...
It's not just Doreen. I tried to get through to Judy and she gave me the brush off too. There's trouble brewing. I'm just sure of it. If Judy starts behaving like that, something must be wrong.
Well, I agree. But until I know what it is, I don't know what you think I can do about it.
Well, the women refuse to talk to me because they don't have to, because I'm not an officer, but you could.
Yes, I could, if I had the time.
This isn't trivial, Jim. I'm not sure what it is, but you've got to make the time.
Yeah, I agree. I've already spoken to Bryant. I got about as far as you did. I don't suppose you'd reconsider about coming back here as an officer.
I don't know. I seem to have trouble making up my mind about anything these days.
Are there problems?
Bob's going on a buying trip to Indonesia for 6 months.
6 months?
Well, it's too good an opportunity to turn down. It'd be wonderful for the business.
And I suppose you'll be going with him.
I don't know. If I don't, it means I'll be away from him for 6 months. I just don't know whether the job's worth it. Oh, maybe I'm not good at the job anyway.
What do you want to do?
I don't know. I just don't know.
So, he says to me, do you want the job or not?
What did you say?
Oh, I didn't take it, bugger. If I had, I'd been rolling in dough by now.
The real problem with you is that you won't put yourself on the line. Now, if I pick a winner, I stick with it. Know what I mean?
Yeah, but...
Yeah, but nothing. I'll show you. Got a fag door?
I don't smoke.
I'll have to remember that. What about your little playmates? Lil? Bev?
They haven't got none either. We're all out and the buy-up isn't till tomorrow.
Oh, I think they might have one or two stashed away somewhere. Don't you think, Hayes?
You get lung cancer if you go on chain smoking like that, Sandy.
Only the good die, young kiddo. Or maybe you think you're one of the good.
Hand them over, then.
You lot surprise me. For a minute there, I thought you were going to stick by Judy's little helper. Light it for me, will you, Beth?
Oh, I don't know what to do. Whether to go with Bob to Indonesia or what will happen if I stay. Perhaps I'm just not cut out to be a counsellor.
You're still worried about Linda Goldman, aren't you?
I'm going to a funeral this afternoon.
Oh, that won't be easy. Look, it still doesn't mean that you're not good at what you do.
Perhaps I should come back here as an officer.
Could do worse.
Could I?
Well, according to the inmates, you're one of the best.
Compared with what?
Well, if I was that good, I just wouldn't consider leaving.
Well, anyone who can get B. Smith on side deserves a medal.
Luck of the draw.
And not with B.
Yeah. Well, better get back to it.
Janet, when we were talking about the television yesterday, you became very secretive. And you're the same now. Why? Look, I'm not an officer, you know.
Yeah, well, it would be a relief to tell someone about it. And I did lie to you the other day.
Well, whatever you say to me is in the strictest confidence.
I was in here on remand 12 years ago.
What
What for? Receiving stolen goods. Oh, it involved my brother, you know, Conway discounts.
I see.
Yeah, well, I wasn't convicted. But B was in here at the same time on remand. I liked her. She was very good to me. I just never thought I'd see her again under these circumstances.
Does the department know?
Not that I know. I mean, I wasn't convicted. If I had been, I would have told them.
Well, I suppose that's fair enough. Mind you, I'd love to see their faces if they found out.
Well, I was innocent. I don't see why I should have jeopardized my career by dragging things up from the past.
Oh, I can see your point.
But it wasn't easy, believe me.
Oh, I can imagine. Does anyone else know?
Well, only B, and she said she wouldn't tell.
Not as long as you keep sweet, anyway.
I suppose you think that I've been dishonest.
No. Have you told you?
Oh, yeah, sure. Now, why should I do that and destroy everything?
That isn't what I meant.
What did you mean?
Look, I may not be the greatest counsellor, but... I mean, in... you and Jim.
No. Well...
I think you should tell him. And what you tell him, or don't tell him, is entirely up to you.
We're late for lunch muster as it is.
Look, ever since you got that job in reception, you've been top suck. Next to B, of course.
Oh, well, if that's all you wanted to say to me...
Look, unless you move pretty fast, Sandy's going to be holding all the cards. She's already got Lil and Bev on her side.
You sure?
Yeah, I saw it with my own eyes. You've got to do something now.
Hazel and Lil and Bev? Well, there's other fish in the sea.
Unless you get the numbers,
Judy. There's Lorna, there's Pam, Shirley,
plenty. Do you reckon you'll get them on side?
Of course.
Geez, I hope so.
Listen, honey, when your Auntie Jude makes a promise, she keeps it.
I knew you'd come good.
What are we waiting for? Let's round up the troops.
Yes. Oh, no, not more paperwork.
Well, not exactly.
Next week's roster.
Yeah, well, I know they're not complete, but then I thought if it's okay with you that maybe I could do them. I mean, they seem quite straightforward.
Yes, well, they're not. Look, I really appreciate this, but until you're familiar with all the union regulations, there are just too many traps that you could fall into.
Well, it was just a thought.
Now, you've got enough on your plate without taking on anything else. Not that I couldn't use the extra pair of hands. You know, you seem to have been in and out of here every 5 minutes over the past couple of days, and all we've had a chance to talk about has been Wentworth's problems.
Well, that's what we're here for.
Yeah, maybe officially, but...
And you're very busy.
I'm not that busy. I'd let you go.
Yes. What are you doing for lunch?
Well, nothing. I was just going to have some...
Good.
Sheets.
But the bell's gone.
I like to finish what I've started. Rita, Andy, tidy up that stuff. Well, I was wondering where you lot got to. I don't know how you expect me to run the laundry shorthanded.
You won't be running it much longer.
How's that?
I'm taking over. You and whose army?
Just us. And if you know what's good for you, you'll butt out.
Come on, Lorna, stop messing about. I seem to have run out of smokes again.
Oh, well, Lil and Bev and me are skint. Maybe Nola's got some. Well, come on, Nola. Cigarettes.
Don't keep me waiting, love.
Nola. Only three? Is that the best you can do?
Okay, maybe the other one's got some.
Pam? Well, hand them over.
Don't. Better get with the strength. Well, looks like you two have lost your little playmates. Come along then, kiddies. There won't be any lunch left if we don't get a wriggle on.
Well?
Forget it. What's the point anyway?
Come in. What's this?
Well, I noticed at dinner the other night that you had a sweet tooth, and there's this really terrific French pastry shop on the way to work, so I thought you might like them for lunch.
Well, thanks. I really appreciate the thought, but, well, I hope you didn't tell anybody, did you?
No. Why?
Oh, nothing really. It's just that, well, rumours spread like wildfire in this place. You know, discretion and all that.
Well, I hardly think a couple of French pastries are going to alert the whole prison. Besides, you didn't seem too concerned about discretion when you kissed me earlier.
No, perhaps I should practice what I preach, eh?
I mean, it's not that I didn't like it. I did. It's just that it was unexpected.
Yeah, well, I suppose I got a bit carried away after our night out. You know, I really enjoyed myself. And I don't see why, with a bit of discretion, it shouldn't continue. Do you?
No. Enjoy the pastries.
How's it going? Can't complain. Must make a change from the usual run-of-the-mill chores around this place.
Is something the matter?
What? Oh, no, I was just having difficulty locating a medical book.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
How do you mean?
Well, there used to be some, but they would have all been snaffled by Lizzie. She's quite an old hypochondriac.
Well, I can hardly say I blame her. Must be pretty frightening to think you're ill, and there isn't even a doctor to take you seriously. I would have thought that was one of the greatest drawbacks about being imprisoned.
The greatest drawback is not having any privacy, and that's why I came in here.
Have you got a headache?
What?
You don't seem to be concentrating too well.
I'd do a whole lot better if I could get some peace and quiet.
I just thought
I'm trying to think too. Now, do you mind?
I'm sorry.
Finding your feet, then?
Yeah, I was a bit shaky at first, but...
We'll have to start somewhere.
Well, I think it's a matter of not overreacting. I mean, most of the women seem pretty reasonable when you get to know them.
I've heard that before.
Mrs. Powell?
What are you doing here, Peterson?
I wanted to see the governor.
Oh, did you now?
I know I'm entitled to see Mr. Fletcher.
What's it in relation to?
Well, it's a personal matter.
No, I said, what's it to do with?
And I said it was personal.
Well, I'm sorry, Peterson, it'll have to wait. You'll need an officer to escort you, and I can't spare a staff member for some little whim.
I can assure you it's not a little whim.
Well, I've got a few minutes before I go back on duty. I could escort Peterson.
Thank you, Miss Conway.
Come along, then.
Come in.
Peterson would like to see you.
Shower him, please, Miss Conway.
Come in, Peterson.
What can I do for you, Peterson?
I know the regulations, Mr. Fletcher, but it is a private matter.
Wait for us outside, please, Miss Conway. Sit down, Peterson.
Thank you. I've just spent some time in the library, and I can't find any medical books.
Surely that's not surprising, is it?
Well, B. Smith seemed to think that Lizzie Birdsworth might have snaffled them.
Ah, yes. I take your point. But that's not what I meant. Surely you must appreciate that most of the inmates in here would have no demand on literature like that.
Well, I suppose not, but... Well, there must be some medical books somewhere. In the infirmary, for example.
Well, there are. Yeah, but they're not for the use of inmates.
As you know, I was a doctor before. Well, I know I can't do anything practically, but I would at least like to keep my mind active. I really can't do that on whodunits.
Yes, it must be very frustrating for you in here.
Yes, that's an understatement.
You realise, of course, that you'll probably be deregistered because of your crime.
Yes. But it hasn't happened yet, and, well, surely in the meantime, there's no harm in my keeping up. The other women have reading matter to suit their tastes. Why not me?
All right, Peterson, under the circumstances, I can see no harm in it. I'll inform the sister that you have permission to consult medical books, but you won't be able to take them outside the infirmary.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher. You've been more than reasonable.
Abby, mind if I have a chat?
Why should I? Everyone else does.
What?
Oh, nothing, Mrs. Morris.
Do you want to talk about Lizzie?
What, again?
Well, obviously she isn't coping very well.
I hope sticks. She seems to be doing all right to me.
What about the story of the moving plant?
Like I said, probably one too many sucks of the sauce bottle.
Perhaps she's putting it on?
Now, why would she do that?
Oh, come on, Bee. You know that every time Lizzie's been released, it's taken her exactly 5 minutes to cook up an elaborate scheme to get back into Wentworth again.
Yes, but this time I think she really wants to make a go of it. Besides, now she's got the security of her own home.
Oh, Wentworth's far more secure. Emotionally secure.
What do you want me to do about it?
I just wanted your advice. You know her better than anyone.
For God's sake, all I want is some peace and quiet. I am not everyone's keeper.
Well, what's wrong, Bee?
I am just sick to death of all these interruptions. All I want to do is sit here and get on with it. And everyone keeps coming in here and asking me stupid bloody questions.
Well, I'm sorry to disturb you, but Lizzie does have problems.
You know what I think? I think that if everyone minded their own damn business, these problems would sort themselves out.
Well, I'm afraid as a counsellor, I can't agree with you. My job is to help people.
Maybe you'd help more by just butting out.
I'm sorry to disturb you.
Morning, Mrs. Birdsworth.
Oh! Frighten the living daylights out of me.
Sorry, I didn't mean to frighten you.
Oh, doesn't take much these days. I'm as jumpy as a cat.
Well, you're not looking the best. If you don't mind me saying, you haven't improved much since I last saw you.
You wouldn't either if you'd been through what I've been through.
Why, what's been happening this time?
Funny phone calls all night long.
Funny phone calls? In what way?
Same as before. Every time it rings and I answer it, there's nobody there.
You sure?
Of course I'm bloody sure. Somebody's trying to get at me.
Think you're letting your imagination run away with you.
Yeah. Like finding that photo of Sid in the kitchen drawer. Fair gives me the creeps when I think about it. Like Sid coming back from the dead. At least that's what somebody wants me to think.
You're sounding a bit paranoid as well.
Hey.
Garden's looking lovely. Must have put a lot of hard work into it.
Yeah. That's how Sid would have wanted it.
Look at that azalea. Isn't it flourishing?
And why wouldn't it? I got a couple of good green thumbs.
Yeah, not bad for a plant that walks, eh?
How did you know that?
Well, you told me, don't you remember? My plants don't have legs and they don't walk, Mrs. Birdsworth.
I never told anybody except Mrs. Morrison B. You did it, didn't you?
What on earth are you talking about?
The plant that moved, the phone ringing all night, the picture of Sid in the drawer. I might be getting on, but I've still got my wits about me. You did it. I can feel it in me bones.
Now, listen here.
You did it, didn't you? You underhand mongrel. You never liked me, did you? The only thing you ever thought about was your father's money after he died. I've seen nicer things than you wriggling around in rat traps.
Lizzie!
Oh, good day, Mrs. Powell.
What is going on? The whole street will hear you.
I think she's had a touch of the sun.
Touch of the sun, my eye.
Well, a bottle more likely.
He's trying to get me out of this house.
Keep your voice down and don't be so stupid.
Mrs. Morris's azalea's been moved twice.
Oh, they all get like that. My father was the same. He'd put something in a cupboard, then swear somebody'd stolen. It would always turn up.
And what about that photo that was planted in the drawer when my back was turned when I was making a cuppa?
You probably put it there yourself.
Ha ha! Funny that it got there just after this one left.
Oh, really?
Oh, and what about the phone calls? Nobody else could have done them. Phone ringing night and day.
You know what kids are like. Now, it was probably some young lad who gets his kicks out of terrorising old ladies.
Yeah, and I know who the lout was and not so bloody young either.
Oh, you're quite wrong, Mrs. Birdsworth.
Oh, no, I'm not. You know me, Mrs. Powell.
Yes.
It's a pity you're so hostile towards me.
Look, I'm sorry. I must apologise for this.
Don't you apologise for me.
Get inside and calm down.
I will go inside when I feel like
it. That is an order.
Oh, go and bite your back. You can't order me about. I'm a free woman.
All right, but you are disturbing the peace.
And what about me? Nobody cares who disturbs me. Oh, what's the use?
Dear, dear, dear.
Well, I've said it before. She shouldn't have been allowed out.
Ah, sister.
Now, this is Kate Peterson.
Well, you look healthy enough to me. What's wrong?
Peterson is, or was, a doctor.
I see.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher has given permission for her to consult the medical books here.
Any particular reason?
No, just to keep my hand in.
Well, I'll leave you to it. Could you phone for an escort to take her back in about an hour?
Mm-hmm. Thanks, Miss Conway.
Was there anything in particular?
Well, I thought a book on neurology to start with.
There you are.
Headaches from A to Z.
Where'd you train?
Melbourne.
What year did you graduate?
1973. I am in the register, if you'd like to check up on it.
No, well, I suppose I'd better let you get on with it. Doctor...
I think you're expected to call me Peterson, like the rest of them.
All right, Peterson. But remember, only an hour.
Hi, Meg. Colour suits you. Going somewhere special.
Linda Goldman's funeral.
Oh, right. Yes, sorry, I forgot.
It's all right.
You seen anything of Birdsworth lately?
Yes, why?
She is going to drive me mad before long.
What do you mean?
I was leaving home after lunch and heard this terrific row. She was going at it, hammer and tongs.
Who with?
Gordon Humphrey. She accused him of terrorizing her.
What was he doing there?
Oh, paying a social call.
Are you sure?
Yes, why else?
He's always been rather nasty to her in the past.
He's been nasty to her. You should have heard what she called him. Every name under the sun.
I don't blame Lizzie if she feels she's been got at. I don't like the man myself.
I don't see how you can dislike him. He seems a perfect gentleman. And to be subjected to an outburst like that when he was only trying to be kind.
Come up your high horse, Colleen.
Well, if she's going to behave like that, I'm not too happy having her as a neighbour. It's always been a very pleasant area. We've never had this sort of trouble.
Give her time, Colleen. Can't be easy for her after all these years inside. Look, I have to go.
Ah, hello, Lizzie. How are you?
Can I see B?
Yeah, of course. Sign in first, though, will you? I'll get Officer Barfield to take you through to the interview room. I have to look at that bag first, though, Lizzie. You settling in all right?
I suppose so.
Well, Mrs. Morris told me that she gave you an azalea as a housewarming present.
Can we go now?
Yes, of course.
Why didn't you just take the phone off the hook?
I didn't think of that. Anyway, it was pottering around the garden, and in it walked, bold as brass.
What?
Chatty as you like. And then he said something, and I twigged straight away. If he hadn't moved that plant, well, how did he know about it?
Well, who had moved what?
I was just getting around
but
to
I'm
that.
I'm sorry. If you just... Look, hang on a minute. Lizzie, you're getting me all confused.
It's not you that's confused, it's him. The slimy, greasy, yellow belly.
Lizzie!
What?
Look, you're not making any sense.
Don't you believe me?
Well, how can I believe you?
I thought you'd understand. You were the only one I could think of. I mean, even Mrs. Morris doesn't seem to catch on.
Well, I'm not surprised if you're carrying on like this.
I see. I thought I could depend on you. I thought you were my friend. Lizzie!
Away.
It's not very loud.
Do as you're told, Hazel, or I'll ram those teeth down your throat. Control yourself, Smith. Do it.
All right.
You might want your eardrums busted. That's your own business.
But I don't.
It wasn't loud, really.
Normal, in fact. If anything that happens around here can be called normal.
It was full blast, I tell you.
Lizzie Birdsworth came visiting today. She seemed a bit cranky.
How do you mean?
Well, you know how she normally is, full of cheek and back chat. Well, she just didn't seem to care anymore.
Well, perhaps she's just growing out of the old prison routine.
Yeah, well, I doubt it. Anyway, sit down. Tell me your troubles.
Yes, there is something I want to discuss with you. I put it off long enough.
Fire away.
I've given it careful consideration. I'd like to return to Wentworth.
As a prison officer? Well, that's great. I mean, you know how I've always felt about that, but... Well, you've been refusing for so long. What made you change your mind?
Just come back from Linda Goldman's funeral. If I had been any good as a counsellor, it would never have happened.
Oh, come on, Meg, you can't blame
if
yourself.
If I had had any sensitivity, I would have been able to see what was happening. But I didn't see it, even though it was staring me in the face.
Meg, you're only human.
It was my fault, Jim. Oh, if you could have seen Linda Goldman's father today.
Look, Meg, I know it's not going to be easy, but really you're going to have to push all that to the back of your mind.
Yes. Well, that's why I've decided to come back here. I was a good officer. At least I thought I was.
Oh, you were the best. Even the women thought so.
I don't know what Bob's going to think of it.
Well, he's not unreasonable. He must understand how you feel.
Hope so.
Anyway, I'm sure your being happy is all that he worries about. Welcome back.
Bugger off!
Mrs. Birdsworth, I'd like a word with you, please.
If you don't get off these premises, I'll have you up for trespassing.
Mrs. Birdsworth, you seem to forget that I own this house.
Not until I'm dead, you don't. So what do you want?
Just thought you'd like to know that you were quite right about me.
You mean about the azalea? Those phone calls? And that photo?
That's right.
I knew it. I bloody well knew it. And you got the cheek to come here visiting?
Let's go inside.
Oh, not on your life. You don't set one
foot in. Take it your own way, Mrs. Birdsworth, but I intend to get you out of here.
It's mine. It's all legal. I can live here till I die.
Look, this is a valuable property. I could get good rent for it.
You mean you want other people living here?
Yes, that's right. Decent people who pay a decent rent.
Well, and what about the garden? Sid built that up. No one can look after it the way I do, the way Sid wanted
it. I don't give a damn about the garden.
Oh, well, it's not as easy as that, Mr. Humphrey. Sid left me this house in his will. You're gonna have to take me to court.
Well, if I have to take you to court, I will. Come to think of it, it shouldn't be too hard to persuade people that you're a danger to yourself and other people. When Mrs. Powell already thinks that. It's a nice idea.
Listen, sonny boy. I've been to court more often than you've had hot breakfast. I know what happens. And I'm not going to let you get away with anything.
Ah, here. Let me give you a hand with that.
Thank you.
I was a bit worried that I might have missed you.
Why?
Well, Meg Morris called in to see me in the office and, one thing led to another and then more paperwork.
Well, a governor's work is never done.
Well, fortunately, it will be in about half an hour, so then I'll be free for the evening. Well, I thought that we might go out somewhere, see a show, have a meal, whatever you like.
Oh.
That is, of course, if you're free.
Well, actually, I'm not. I've got to wash my hair.
Ah. Well, tomorrow night, then.
Well, I don't think that would be a very good idea either.
Why not?
Well, you said yourself that we have to be discreet.
Oh, yeah, well, in here we do. But what we do outside this place is nobody's business but our own. Look, what's got into you?
Get me wrong. I like you. I really do.
Then come out with me tonight. Forget about your hair. It looks great. It's wonderful.
No, Jim, I can't. Maybe another time.
You'll ruin your eyes trying to read in this light.
I'm okay.
I don't think you are.
Well, what would you know?
I'm a doctor, remember?
How could I forget?
You know, the TV wasn't any louder than normal tonight.
You know, you've only been here 5 minutes.
I also noticed you didn't eat much at dinner.
That slop? Well, do you blame me?
I think the food here is disgusting, but you've been here a long time, Bea. You must be used to it by now.
Well, maybe I'm getting choosy in my old age.
I had the chance to study some medical books today in the infirmary.
Well, lucky you. I'm glad someone's getting some peace and quiet.
I looked up your symptoms.
What symptoms?
Nausea, dizziness, loss of appetite, headaches, irritability.
Whoever said that I
had... I'm a qualified doctor, B. I had a pretty good idea what those symptoms meant. And I confirmed them in one of the books.
Why don't you just
butt out.
And why don't you see a doctor?
No.
Look, I can't do anything in here, but ethically, as a medical practitioner, I have to make your state of health known so you can have some help.
You tell anyone what you know and you'll be worrying about your state of health.
Do you really know what's wrong with you?
My mother had it. And her sister. Yeah, I know what's wrong with me. And I know you doctors have a lot of fancy names for it. Carcinoma, melanoma. Call it what you will, it all boils down to the same thing, doesn't it?
Cancer.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. And things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. And the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together. Sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.